2020 has been a tough year for businesses, with many believing it would take up to 5 years to return to pre-COVID profitability levels. Leading firms through these headwinds will be Lam Yee Yong, current Deputy CEO of the Singapore Business Federation. He will succeed current CEO Ho Meng Kit, who is retiring on 1st January after 10 years at the helm. Mr. Lam joins us tonight to share more about his plans for SBF in the coming years. Mr. Lam, well, you know, a recent survey shows more than 25% of Singapore businesses believe 2025 is the earliest for them to return to pre-COVID days. So why this pessimism?
Well, I think to understand that, we have to first understand that the 6 to 6.5% economic contraction that we're expecting this year is quite a severe contraction. It effectively wipes out more than 2 years' worth of economic growth. And the second and probably more important factor is that the impact of the pandemic has been very uneven across different sectors and across different companies. Some are much more affected than others. And even as we go into the recovery likewise will be uneven, maybe even more uneven than the initial impact. So at one end, we will see companies that are doing quite well, have recovered more or less to pre-COVID level, maybe have even gone even higher than the pre-COVID level, and they are in a good position for further growth, to seize opportunity and grow even more over the next few years. But at the other end of the spectrum, we have companies that continue to be badly affected by the pandemic and for which recovery is not going to come till a few years later. So particularly sectors like aviation and tourism, until there can be resumption of mass air travel, which I think most people don't expect it in the, so soon, they will continue to be badly impacted. And for these companies, recovery is going to come later. And based on my conversation with the industry, the more impacted one, they are looking at anywhere from 2024 to 2026 to be able to recover to pre-COVID levels.
Mr. Lam, what immediate plans do you have for SBF to help members tide through, you know, till they're back to pre-COVID profitability?
So this unevenness, it also poses extra challenges to SBF in that we have to help our members and the wider business community across the whole spectrum, from those that are doing well and want to grow further towards those that are still badly affected and need more help. So in terms of the help that we are providing, I think we can look at it in terms of three key areas. The first is internationalization, helping companies who are able to venture and expand overseas so as to grow their business even further. And the second area is about digitalization and transformation, helping companies to take the current opportunity to transform their business, transform their processes, and also adopt digital and other technologies so that they can become more competitive and emerge stronger from the crisis. And the third area is jobs and skills. This is really about helping companies handle and manage their manpower challenges, not just the current challenges, but also looking at redesigning their jobs and upskilling their workers so as to prepare for the future.
Mr. Lam, in your work, you know, what are the challenges faced in reaching out to businesses, especially in these times, and addressing their needs?
I think one of the challenges really for some businesses, they are really very preoccupied with a lot of the current day challenges, cash flow issues, manpower issues, that sometimes it takes a bit of convincing to talk to them and to tell them about the need to think also about the future, to think about transforming, about adopting technology, about exploring new markets, and about pivoting into new areas of business. So that's something that we will continue to work on, to reach out to as many companies as we can, beyond those that have that we are already working with and helping.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Lam Yee Yong there. He's the incoming CEO and current Deputy CEO of the Singapore Business Federation.